If it takes you more than 10 minutes to drain a water heater, I want you to watch this video. I hate it when contractors don't give a flying F. You know what I mean? Come on. That's just gross. Knock, knock. The boss is here.
Hi.
That sounds funny, actually.
Hi.
Knock, knock. The boss is here. I just came back from a job in Far Rockaway where pilot is out. Mm-hmm. Put the new thermocouple in. Stays lit for like, I don't know, a minute until I actually fire it up and then pilot goes out. That's a 50, right?
EGX250.
Good, okay. Yeah, that one is definitely no bueno. Wow, we are going to make these shine, ladies and gentlemen. These two Burnham Series 2 hydronic atmospheric venting gas-fired boilers. These are from the early 2000s. Abracadabra. I had to leave the other one in the filth that it was still sitting in so you could see a side by side. And that's how you service a heating system. All right, we got this A.O. Smith 50 gallon gas fired water heater. She's literally on her last legs. As you can see, she's been rusting up, she's been leaking. One of the first things we do, we pull out the drain valve from the bottom of the water heater because it's restrictive. It is very restrictive. You know what? How much water do you think you're going to pass through that opening right there? There's a reason why they call it full port valves now versus these restrictive valves. We take out the valve. We put in a 3/4 inch nipple. It could be brass. Could be galvanized. It could be black. Could be whatever. Throw a ball valve on it. Right, and then throw another fitting on there with a hose connection and dump that with a laundromat wash machine hose. Look at the thickness of this hose versus that hose. This is our garden hose. This is our laundromat washing machine hose. This is full port. It is almost 3/4 of inside diameter. And we will drain this literally in about 5 minutes. Do any of you care to wager that this will take more than 5 minutes to fully drain? Anyone want to wager? Let's go. Yeah. This basement got destroyed. Literally got destroyed. A cast iron radiator blew out. Froze. We're using the Milwaukee M18 Transfer Pump here. It's battery operated. We have it going outside to a safe spot where we know the water is not going to stain any paving stones or any cement. So, ladies and gentlemen, who's wagering more than 5 minutes? If you're wagering more than 5 minutes, you might as well pick up your sister's panties and go home because you're going to lose. I guarantee.
Yeah, I'm recording this. This is funny watching you struggle sometimes.
It's how you build muscles. Is that what Nana Claire says?
No.
No. I'm sure she likes her men strong. Was her husband strong? Your grandfather strong?
I don't know. He's old when I knew him.
Oh.
He's a lot older than her, like 20-something
years. Oh man! So. Wow. All right, she got herself an older man, a distinguished gentleman. All right, so right now we're disconnecting the gas. That gas cock, the gas valve there, 3/4, it's off. If it's an older T-style one, you're going to want to change that. Don't leave that there, and you're going to turn off the gas service to the building, and then make sure you do a pressure test, or leak test, sorry, when you're done. Soapy water. Great for finding any kind of gas leaks. So today we are going to take out this 50-gallon A.O. Smith water heater from the early 2000s, right around the turn of the century, the 21st century. And it's going to the water heater heaven. Now, this was a duplex. It was a two-family house. There's a reason why there's two boilers and there's two water heaters for floor one and floor two. They are separate, and I did do my due diligence to see if we could just avoid having two water heaters, but it's a lot of work to switch them back over because everything is separate now. And also, if they ever want to convert it back to a duplex, a two-family house, they're already set up for that. Oh, wow. It's like a scrapyard here. Look at that. 8:30. It's done. She's a wobbler. She's a wobbler. Yay! That's okay. Look at this basement. Okay. Who had the over five? You guys lost.
Daniel, you think anyone's going to notice that that took 7.5 minutes to drain?
I think everybody would have noticed if you didn't drain.
All right. We are going to manhandle this water heater out of here. And then we are going to say have a nice day. All right, the new water heater is kind of in position. I wrapped some Blue Monster PTFE tape, also known as Teflon tape, on the cold water inlet. This is the dielectric nipple, and also the hot water outlet, also a dielectric nipple. You're going to notice that the finished product is not going to show a vacuum breaker. In my jurisdiction, which is the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, it's not required. What is required is a means to absorb pressure in a closed automatic storage domestic hot water situation. So if I have a backflow prevention device on my water main, I shall install a version of this for potable water on my water main. Now, there's a difference between a hydronic expansion tank and a domestic water, potable water expansion tank. And the main difference is the tapping on the bottom. Is for hydronic is going to be 1/2 inch. On our domestic potable water is going to be 3/4. And which matches up to usually our pipe sizing. We're going to throw 2 3/4 press by female adapters on my inlet and my outlet. We're going to clean up our existing copper lines with some scratchy paper, also known as open grit paper or emery paper. We're going to tighten up those male adapters. Ooh, that one's tight. That one's going to be fun. Yeah. We'll make it happen, though. Think we can make it happen?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see what you're going to do. Yeah, he's using his noggin. Moves it out of the way. He's going to tighten that up. Sweet. There we go. Nicey nice. Now, Daniel thinks it didn't get in all the way. Okay, so you hold that. You show the people. Good luck getting this thing out now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow. Oh, yeah, see? See? If you don't show and tell, you didn't do it.
Mikey Pipes, you didn't debury the pipes.
You want a bet? Look at that, looks so nice. And our gas will line up perfectly. Should we fill it up?
I'll fill it.
About 35 minutes into the job. Not too shabby, huh? Yeah. Can't make this up. If it wasn't on video, you wouldn't believe it. We have a temperature and pressure safety valve that's defective out of the box. See? Crazy. Is They're still passing water through. Crazy. All right, we have the domestic cold water isolated. We gotta get the water out of here and swap out the temperature and pressure valve, and then we'll put a claim in with A.O. Smith, and they'll pay me $140 for an hour of labor because they like to rip me off and everyone else off. And then we'll bill out for the temperature and pressure safety valve, and then in about a month from now, I'll get a check. But generally, A.O. Smith, great, great product brand. That's all we install for domestic water. Water heating purposes, their X3 tankless system never needs to be descaled. There's practically no service. Let's swap out the valve. Yeah. Oh, well. You know, that old thing is right. If you ain't showing it, you didn't do it. Why do they say that, by the way? Do they not believe you? You know, is that what it's about? It's got to be that, right? That people don't believe. Well, at least we have about a, maybe about a pound of mango to put onto the mango bin.
It was actually over 150
psi water. Well, for as long as the thing took to fill, yeah. Oh, Mikey Pipes, why'd you change the temperature and pressure of the safety valve? It could have just been too much pressure in the house. You know what? You know what I'm gonna get? I'm gonna go get now. You have?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Come on, baby. Get back on there.
Oh, no. It sucks.
Oh, no.
It stinks.
It does stink. But you know what? Guess what? I got my bluefin one. Now, granted, it stuck around 10 PSI. It works. And it's been sitting in my truck for as long as supplyhouse.com has been carrying bluefin. So whatever it is, minus 10. You a flat screwdriver? True HVAC guy doesn't have screwdrivers. He has 10s and 1s, 20s and 1s. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, it would help if I turn the pressure on. Let's see what she stops at when she's done filling. What do you think it's going to be at?
60-ish around there.
40.
Technically it'd be 70-ish.
50. 60. 60. I'd say 64 minus 10. 54 pounds of pressure. See? If you ain't testing, you're guessing, right? I showed you guys. You won't catch me laying on the floor to light a pilot. Not in a rainy water here, that's for sure. Houston, we have ignition. All right, we have a few screws in the draft hood, and we have 3 screws per joint on our flue piping. Even though it's existing and there was none in there before, we touched it, we own it. So now we have 3 screws per joint. Sweet. Excellent. Love A.O. Smith. Hashtag. And don't worry, I didn't forget about the leak in temperature and pressure safety valve, because they're going to pay. So ladies and gentlemen, if you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, and your water heater's on the fritz, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call at 516-348-6300. We exclusively install A.O. Smith water heaters. They're great water heaters. They're amazing. And we have them in stock. We have 40 and 50 gallon standard height and low boys. We have 40 and 50 gallon power vented. And we stock the A.O. Smith X3 tankless water heater, which never, ever, ever needs to be descaled. And if you don't know what descaling is, do your due diligence before picking me up and ask me if you need a tankless water heater in your home installed. And yes, my company, we replace anode rods, because if you're replacing your water heater in 12, 15 years, you're doing something wrong, and actually your plumber's doing something wrong, and you need to pick up the phone and give me a call. And if you're lazy, scan that QR code. It'll bring you right to my landing page, and you can book a service call right online in the comfort of your own home, in your lazy boy, wearing your pajamas. You don't even have to pick up the phone and to call. Book online. Scan this QR code. Do it now. What are you waiting for?